Deutsche Bank plans 18,000 jobs cuts in robot strategy called Operations 4.0. All of these people were inevitably going to lose their jobs anyway because the bank is completely insolvent. This is just Deutsche Bank trying to spin thousands of layoffs in their favor. But as we can all see, a final Hail Mary is pure desperation, not innovation. Deutsche Bank, the evil drowning behemoth up to its beady eyeballs in toxic derivatives. When will this slimy beast finally be harpooned, reeled in, and its blubber boiled for oil lamps? About the same time, USA launches its civil war reloaded between the deplorable and the exceptionals as the fiat filth IOU Saudi American Petro toilet paper dollar gets flushed from the Ponzi sewer global bankster system. I think this is a controlled collapse. We'll see if they can do it quick enough. I do not think. Maybe all the robot customers will come rushing into such a progressive bank. Looking forward to robots buying from robots when the breathing serfs have no purchasing power left. Once the human workers have been replaced by algos, chatbots, and Roomba cleaners, the new smart workforce will, of course, realize that the management and board have caused all of Deutsche Bank's problems, are holding the company back, and need to be replaced with nothing. Will the robots be as good at manipulating gold and laundering loot as the humans were? This makes me very worried. Who are the executives going to blame next time Deutsche Bank gets caught manipulating PMs, bonds and LIBOR rates, stealing from their customers' accounts and committing fraud, when there isn't even a janitor in the house? The poor executives might face scrutiny for their psychopathic actions. Forgive my ignorance, but what the hell happens to $45 trillion in derivatives if Deutsche Bank fails? Blame the robots. Welcome to the Atlantis Report. Only Deutsche Bank, the largest bank in Germany, is significantly exposed, holding dubious financial products known as derivatives, worth 67 trillion euros. This amount is similar to the GDP of the entire world and 20 times higher than the GDP of Germany. Any comparison with the situation of the bank Lehman Brothers in 2008 would not be irrelevant. Just when Lehman Brothers went bankrupt, it had available derivatives of only 31.5 trillion. The crisis of 2008 confirmed the concise definition of derivatives as proposed by the American tycoon Warren Buffett, financial weapons of mass destruction. Seeing Deutsche Bank stock rising sharply while this is happening to them reminds me a lot of the Nortel days in 2000 when every quarter they would lay off hundreds of engineers, technicians in most of their sites all over the world. The stock would flare on those events because it temporarily made the finances look better. The ultimate direction was obviously down over the long run, though, obviously. With these Deutsche Bank plans 18,000 jobs cuts. They are not referring to bankers, only the automatable staff that push buttons and red computer screens. A billion-dollar capitalized bank will only need 50 executives and no one else. My local grocery store has a third of its checkout without humans. I use the human line and cash. Never give up your landline or use of cash. In place of banknote debt obligations, I'd like to see gold and silver use return. There is no counterparty risk or fees attached to paying in gold or silver. Will trillions of dark, digital, paper fiat from governments save the company, or will they let the derivatives go into a domino reaction across the world's banking system? Can the ESF's coke and heroin dollars be used? Deutsche Bank admitted to paying mid-level managers many hundreds of thousands of dollars per year. To merely manage a bank. Imagine for a moment. You're an engineer, maybe making $100,000 per year at best, a little more if you work in the Silicon Valley, lending your money to an institution that pays its managers several times that. These megabanks are so much more than banks. Megabanks in today's context are extensions of central banks and governments. They stand ready to participate in whatever needs to be done, extend liquidity, launder money, purchase sovereign bonds, or pay off scumbags. Think of Facebook. Is it just a tech company or a massive extension of the deep state intelligence? I think we know the answer to this. Here is the deal. We all need to adjust our fundamental view of reality. I am a natural skeptic, but I know that even I am way behind in understanding the fabricated state of criminal cartels in the world. This clay-footed bank with minus equity is supposed to be able to answer to its shout of issuing $45 trillion worth of derivatives in case, equaling to two-thirds world's annual GNP, an exciting and simultaneously so soothing equation. Deutsche Bank had about 100,000 employees in 2000 and about 91,000 in 2019, so this will be pretty close to 20% headcount reduction more or less, and this is substantial. It's not nearly enough, of course, but it is a solid start. Financial services is long past due for tech disruption and are no longer able to be used as a jobs program for otherwise unemployable grads as international competition no longer makes high costs supportable. It is the same path, followed as agriculture and manufacturing, which are also internationally tradable. Deutsche Bank Business Plan 4.0 means outsourcing all the crime to AI and machine learning algorithms. I can't remember the last time a computer program went to prison. The machines did it. The machines did it. They taught themselves to do it, and we knew nothing about it. This is the future, and we're almost there. Confiscation by machine where humans are unable to do anything about it as the machine did it. This is how they'll confiscate the lot. The machines taught themselves to do it. This the next big push. Corporations are replacing middle management with automation. We call them robots, but in fact it's just software. Over the next 15 years, this will destroy the middle class. This is the only path forward for many businesses, professions, of which banking might be a primary example. This is precisely what old Jerry Powell simply refuses to accept, and that is that the 21st century will be radically unlike the 20th or any previous century in terms of the rate of change. Deutsche Bank could have been merged with Commerzbank, and much of the cost-cutting accomplished quietly and less disruptively, and now, for some reason, we will get more public job slaughters. When you lay off a robot, does it qualify to receive unemployment? And where do they go when they retire? This is how revolutions start. No one gives a damn about the poor, and it's when the sons and daughters, placed in cushy banking jobs, lose their positions and status is when hell gets real. Soon we will learn who is holding their derivatives and just how much damage they will cause. Expect these derivative holders to plead for a bailout. Derivatives are not real and do not exist in reality, but only on spreadsheets and servers. They are mere casino bets based on fancy math, algorithms, aka economic, financial voodoo, and gambling so that they could extract, skim off the commissions, real money, and bonuses received on every transaction. The bankers care not if these smoke and mirror derivatives work out or not, because they already got their money up front from the transactions. I read some years back that the world's exposure to derivatives was something like $1 quadrillion. There is not that much money in the universe and certainly no $45 trillion to which Deutsche Bank is exposed. By giving credence to these phony baloney contrived financial products, they create unnecessary instability. It is akin to the global warming fools telling us that our doom is just around the corner, yet global warming is more contrived made-up BS to extract even more wealth from us serfs and into the bankers' accounts. They are having a hard time wrapping the head around losing $1 billion a day and still being solvent. The paper trail should be framed as artwork. With Lagarde on her way out, it'll be interesting to see how the predecessor handles this triage. If the bankers that rule the world decided they wanted to raise the standard of living of humanity, to use technology and funds with no usury for the betterment of the society, you think they can't do it? Capitalism is their leeching system, and when it comes down, they will install their new world order, and all of you capitalist sheep will live a life of debt and unhappiness. Your children will be debt slaves and completely controlled zombies through mass media, social media with digital money which can be frozen anytime your rulers want. So, there are 18,000 new people who will no longer need banking services since they don't have an income. Smart. If they keep outsourcing these jobs, who will buy their products and services when people won't have any money since they won't have any jobs? Their products are obsolete, and so are they. The banks have backed themselves into a corner, shot themselves in both feet, and now, they are about to be shot in the head too. Who needs a bank, if they will not lend you money? Who needs a bank that does not reward you for saving? Who needs a bank that needs to spy on you and report your transactions to the IRS? Who needs a bank that treats you like crap and considers you a criminal? Who needs a bank when you can stash gold and avoid losing money with time? Who needs a bank to make payments when you have PayPal, crypto, and cell phone banking? Who needs a bank? Who? Bill Gates said once, "Banking is necessary, banks are not." That was back in 1994. The robot armies are coming, and we've known it for a long time. If you're still in a job that can be automated, you've waited too long to retrain. I don't have much sympathy. Dealing with these hordes of displaced workers will turn out to be the defining crisis of the 21st century. First, there were artificial sweeteners, then artificial butter, artificial diamonds, artificial meat, and now artificial banking. It seems like artificial intelligence has been around for a long time. Why can't we just have artificial government and go back to the real stuff on everything else? Deutsche will be the next Humpty Dumpty. But this time, the Fed, Central Bank, and the IMF won't put things back together again. The counterparties will be jumping out of windows this time. Get your money out. It's earning naff all, and the risk is mounting. Big haircuts coming, BNP is so tied to Deutsche they can't walk away. So they are in a bad situation. Pound-euro trendline broke today, which means euro-dominated debt through RBS just got more expensive. Next big hit to Deutsche. It's all fun and games until you suddenly can't get your money out of the bank anymore. Deutsche Bank, the largest systemically risky bank in the world. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.